go through each one of them rather briefly, and we can bring it up later on. The first one and the most important one, I think, is the concept of nature that we have in Kemet. Nature, if you wish, you could say nature or nater. In nature, which is dialectical in its spoken language, it really doesn't matter how you pronounce it, whether you pronounce it nature or nater or neteru or however. Really doesn't matter. In the writing, it's the same, no matter how it is in the spoken form. Nature is, in the text, seems to be the totality of all existence. It seems to be that everything that exists is nature. And I say that because in the text, it says everything that is, all different kinds of things are referred to as nature. Man is called nature. Plants and animals are called nature. Stones and rocks and trees are called nature. Concepts and principles are called nature. Rivers, the sky, all, everything is called nature or referred to as nature in the text. And so therefore we get the feeling that nature is everything that exists. Nature is nature. All living things are nature. And even Medu Nature, the name of the language of nature, the language of nature, the language of all existence, of all life, is the name of the language itself. When it gets translated into other languages, it gets translated as God. But however, in Medu Nature, there isn't that concept of God. There isn't the same God concept. Nature and the God concept in the Western world are really two very different things. God is a singular entity, a creative force, if you wish, or an overseer of human life and a singular developer of human life. And according to whatever different religion or form of spirituality you believe in, God has its own variations. But for one thing, God is not the same as nature. Because God is not a tree, God is not a stone, God is not man, God is not a river, or God is not the sky. But nature is. Nature is man. I am nature. You are nature. This podium is nature. Everything that exists is nature. The Kemites believe firmly that everything that exists is sustenance for everything else, that all life sustains life. And therefore, everything is divine. Everything is holy. Everything is revered, because everything is sustenance for everything else. And in order for all of, for existence, for life to exist in the healthy, creative, developing form that it exists in, everything must be protected, everything must be taken care of, and in order to keep and maintain the balance and the healthy existence of everything else that exists. So that is what Neter is. We talk about Neteru. The Neteru are all of the various manifestations of light. We are all Neteru. Everything is Neteru. Even though some of the Neteru are named specifically because they are so important or considered important in the element of creation. For example, we've all heard about Seth, Ufir, Heteru, Netethet, Shu, Ma'at. Those are all principles and concepts. Principles and concepts. Jehuti. Jehuti is the principle and concept of learning, wisdom, and knowledge. Ma'at is the principle of harmonious balance in the universe. Aset is the principle of womanhood. And Ufir is the principle of renewal, rebirth, and rejuvenation. They are not gods. In Kemet, they were not worshipped as gods. We cannot talk about gods of the Egyptians or gods of the Kemites. They were never human forms. They were never worshipped or given praises to or praised. As a matter of fact, we always say when we're learning Medu Nature, one of the things you see right up front is that it's never spoken of as Nature being praised by man. So therefore, these are not gods, but these are Neteru. These are principles and concepts in the development, in the cosmology, in the cosmogony, in the creative process of man. The creative process, which itself is felt to be a continuity or a continuous happening. It was never conceived in Kemet as something that happened in the beginning as God created the heaven and the earth. But it is something that is continuously happening all the time according to our ancient texts. And not only that, but there are many, many cosmologies and cosmogonies.